لا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم. اعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الصلاه والسلام على اشرف الانبياء والمرسلين، سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا ومولى الكونين، رسول الثقلين، جد الحسن والحسين، أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المظلومين المكرمين المطهرين المنتجبين المنتخبين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والجنة للمطيعين، والنار للعاصين، واللعنة الدائمة الباقية على أعدائهم من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه تبارك وتعالى في محكم كتابه الكريم، وهو أصدق القائلين وقوله الحق، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: قل لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إلا المودة في القربى. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Dear brothers and sisters, today we are commemorating the Shahadat or death anniversary of Bibi Fatima Masuma alayhi salam. And Bibi Fatima Masuma alayhi salam is one of the sisters of Imam Ridha alayhi salam and one of the daughters of Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam. Bibi Fatima Masuma alayhi salam, inshallah, we'll discuss very briefly that she was one of the greatest ladies in the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam's family after Bibi Zainab alayhi salam. And so she was a role model for all the Shias, and especially for the Shia ladies. And how she showed her love for her brother, the sister showed so much love for her brother that it was very, very amazing to see this kind of love. And today, in our today's society, we find ourselves that the relations are being broken, and the families are falling apart, and people are not comfortable with each other. They do not want to live with each other. They do not want to tolerate each other, and so on and so forth. But this lady, this great personality from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, showed us the way, showed us the path, and showed us how we should love our family members, especially, and sacrifice everything if it is necessary for the sake of our family. And this is what this great lady did. And there is another important point here, that this shows the life of this lady, who did not live in this world for a long time. She was only 28 years old when she passed away, when she left this world. But in this 28 years of her life, she showed us one very important point, and that is, even if you are young, you can do something and you could be a role model. And number two, she showed us that she, though being a woman, and at that time being a woman still was very limiting. You could not do a lot of the things because you were a female. But she she showed us, and before her Janab Zainab alayhi salam, and before Janab Zainab alayhi salam, Bibi Fatima Zahra salamullah alayha, and others had shown us some of the ways in which ladies and women folk, and especially Muslimah, can come out in the society and work for the betterment of the society and do the work of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by supporting the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. So this great lady, she was so important to the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam that there are a number of ahadith from the Aima alayhim as-salam about this lady. For example, I would like to quote Imam Rizal alayhi salam's hadith where he says, "Man zara al-ma'suma biqum kaman zarani," whoever visits ma'suma. And this also a very important point, inshallah I'll talk about it just now. So Imam al-Islam says, whoever visits ma'suma in Qum as if he has visited me. So the ziyarat of this great personality and this great lady is equal to the ziyarat of Imam Ridha alayhi salam. How amazing is that? How amazing. So she had elevated her status so high that the Imam of the time is saying that the ziyarat, the visit to this great lady is equal to my ziyarat. And there is another hadith where Masum alayhi salam have said, "Man zaraha biqum dakhalahu al-jannah," whoever visits her in Qum would inshallah enter Jannah. And there is a hadith where her haram is, according to the hadith, said to be the haram of Janabi Fatimatu Zahra salam alayhi. Let me quote this hadith for you as well, where the Masum says, "Inna lillahi haraman wa huwa Makkah." There is a haram, there is a holy place for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is a sanctuary for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is Makkah. "Wa li rasulihi haraman wa huwa al-Madina." And there is a sanctuary, there is a holy place for the Rasul of Allah, and that is Medina. وَلِ أَمِيرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ حَرَمًا وَهُوَ الْكُوفَ. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam has also a sanctuary and haram, and that is in Kufa. وَلَنَا حَرَمًا وَهُوَ قُمْ. And there is a haram for all the other Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, and that is Qum. So this is something really great. And it actually talks about the importance of the Qum as well. But this, we need to understand that the haram for the rest of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam is Qum. And then there the fadilat and the virtue of this city Qum is also mentioned here. And so Imam continues and says, "Fihi imra'atun min wuldi تسمى فاطمة وسيدفن ستدفن فيه امرأة تسمى فاطمة من ولدي ومن زارها فله الجنة." And she would be from my progeny, and whoever visits her, وجب له الجنة, the Jannah will be for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would grant him Jannah. So this is the status of this great personality, Bibi Fatima al-Masuma alayhi salam. And so this is why she has been given many titles, like Tahira, the pure one, the Hamida, the praised one, Birra, the righteous one, Rashida, the mature one, Taqiyya, the pious one, Naqiyya, the pure one, Radiyya, the contented one, Mardiyya, the one with whom Allah is pleased, Sayyida, Siddiqa, the truthful one, and Ukhtar Rida, yani the sister of Imam Rida alayhi salam. She is also widely known as Karima Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. So this brings us to the point where I said, I talk about the word ma'suma. So Imam said, man zara al-ma'suma kaman zarani, whoever visits the ma'suma as if he has visited me. So her most famous title is Al-Ma'suma. This title is taken from a narration that which I have just recited for you. So this hadith is from the Imam alayhi salam. This is not a statement of an ordinary person. So if the Imam alayhi salam saying that his sister was a ma'suma, it means that she was protected from sin. Although she was not at the level of the ma'sumeen, alayhim as-salam, those are specially, given that status of protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are infallible. But sometimes an individual can elevate his status, his amal, his life, and his spirituality to a certain level where he does or she does not do or commit any sins or even an error. So some of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam have reached, some of the family members from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam had reached that level, like Hazrat Zainab salamullah alayha, Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam, and then this lady Bibi Fatima Masuma alayhi salam. And there is another title for her which is also very famous, and if you go you would find this written on the shrine as well, at one of the doors, Karima Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, which means this lady is known today as the Karima of Ahlul Bayt. It is said that this naming is based on a dream by Sayyid Mahmud al-Marashi al-Najafi, father of Ayatullah Marashi al-Najafi, in which one of the imams alayhim salam called her the Karima of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, which means the generous lady of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, and advised this Sayyid Mahmud al-Marashi to visit her grave. And so there are so many different karamat mentioned for this special lady. And one of the things which is mentioned about her is that she had the knowledge, special knowledge, which she had received from the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. So it's been reported that once a group of Shia entered Medina to ask Imam Al-Kadhim alayhi salam some questions. At the time, the Imam alayhi salam was on a trip outside of Medina. Therefore, Fatima Masuma alayhi salam, wrote the answers to their questions on a piece of paper and handed it to them. On their way back, they encountered the Imam alayhi salam. They met the Imam alayhi salam outside of the town. When the Imam alayhi salam saw the answers to their questions and replies from given by Bibi Ma Fatima Masuma alayhi salam, he said, "May her father be her sacrifice." Amazing. So Imam alayhi salam is repeating this word, these words, and giving her this status. Aur bas ab jo hai Urdu ki taraf mein aata hu ke Imam alayhi salam ne itni buland jo hai wo maqam jo hai wo diya hai, isi wajah se aapke liye ye milta hai ke aap jo hain apne shiyon ki shifaat farmayenge. So isi wajah se, based on some narrations, kuch ahadees ke mutabiq jo hai wo Fatima Masuma alaihi salam ko khudaund alam ki taraf se ek special jo hai wo maqam jo hai wo inayat farmaya gaya hai ke jisme wo apne jo ahle bait alaihi salam ke chahne wale shia hain unki shifaat farmayengi inshaallah, aur jo bhi unki ziyarat ke liye jayega uske liye bhi jannat jo hai wo imam ki hadith ke mutabiq jo hai wo wajib ho jati hai. Bas azan mukram aapki isse zyada jo hai wo aapko aur zehmat nahi dena hai. Ye masuma apne bhai alaihi salam yani imam Riza alaihi salam ki ziyarat ke liye apne ghar yani Madine aur apne watan ko chhod ke nikli thi. जब इनको मालूम हुआ कि इमाम अलैहिस्सलाम जो है वो तकलीफ में हैं, तो अपने भाई की जियारत के लिए और उनसे मुलाकात के लिए آپ جو ہے وہ نکلتی ہیں اپنے بھائیوں کے ساتھ، اپنے محرموں کے ساتھ، لیکن افسوس کی بات یہ ہے کہ وہ زمانہ ایسا زمانہ تھا کہ جب اہل بیت علیہ السلام کے گھر والوں کو اور ان کے چاہنے والوں کو کہیں پر بھی امن نصیب نہیں تھا۔ روایت بتاتی ہے، واقعہ یہ ملتا ہے کہ آپ ایران کے ایک شہر کہ جو قم سے زیادہ دور نہیں ہے، ساوہ کے نام سے ہے، آپ جب وہاں پر پہنچتی ہیں تو وہاں پر حملہ ہوتا ہے اہل بیت علیہ السلام کے اس قافلے کے اوپر، اور اس میں سے جتنے بھی آپ کے بھائی ہوتے ہیں اہل بیت کے چاہنے والے، سب کو جو ہے وہ شہید کر دیا جاتا ہے، اور اس وجہ سے جناب فاطمہ معصومہ علیل ہو جاتی ہیں اور بیمار ہو جاتی ہیں۔ اور پھر اس کے بعد قم، کیونکہ پیغمبر کے زمانے کے بعد سے ہی یوں کہا جا سکتا ہے کہ اہل بیت علیہ السلام کے چاہنے والے وہاں پر جا کے بس گئے تھے، تو اس وجہ سے وہاں پر ایک اہل بیت کے چاہنے والے ہیں کہ جن کا نام ہے موسیٰ ابن خزرج، جب ان کو معلوم ہوتا ہے تو وہ آپ کو قم لے کے آتے ہیں، اور پھر آپ جو ہے وہیں پر ان کے گھر میں جو ہے تشریف لے جاتی ہیں۔ اور یہ بھی روایت بتاتی ہے کہ جب آپ تشریف لا رہی تھیں قم، تو آپ نے کالے جھنڈوں کو دیکھا، کالے پرچم کو دیکھا، اور آپ نے جو ہے وہ دیکھا کہ پورا شہر جو ہے وہ سوگ میں جو ہے مبتلا ہے، سب سوگ منا رہے ہیں۔ تو جب پوچھا تو آپ سے یہ بتایا گیا کہ آپ کے برادر، آپ کے بھائی امام رضا علیہ السلام شہید کر دیے گئے ہیں، اور اس وجہ سے آپ جو ہیں اور بیمار ہو گئیں، اور چند دنوں میں ہی آپ کی شہادت واقع ہو گئی۔ بس میں جناب فاطمہ معصومہ سے ہاتھ جوڑ کے کہوں گا، اے شہزادی آپ سے یہ برداشت نہ ہوا کہ آپ کے بھائی کی شہادت کی خبر آپ کو ملے۔ ہاں، جب آپ کو آپ کے بھائی کی شہادت کی خبر ملی تو آپ اس دنیا میں زیادہ دن زندہ نہ رہ سکی، لیکن ہاں مجھے ایک اور پہل یاد آتی ہے کہ جس کے سامنے اس کے بھائی کو ذبح کیا جا رہا تھا، ہاں وہ آپ کی ہی پھوپھی جدہ ہیں جناب زینب کبریٰ، کہ جو آئی دیکھتی کیا ہے کہ چاروں طرف سے آقا حسین کو گھیرا ہوا ہے، اور چاہتی یہ ہے کہ آقا حسین کو شہید کر دے، سر کو تن سے جدا کر دے۔ ایک مرتبہ جناب زینب کبریٰ آواز دیتی ہے، پسر سعد تو دیکھ رہا ہے میرا ماجایا ذبح ہو رہا ہے، امام نے اشارے سے کہا کہ بہن زینب ابھی حسین زندہ ہے، آپ چلی جائے۔ یہی وہ زینب تھی کہ جنہوں نے آقا حسین کے مشن کو زندہ رکھا، اور آج بھی یہ عزاداری آقا حسین کے مشن کے زندہ ہونے کی علامت بنی ہوئی ہے، اور جو پوری دنیا میں پھیل چکی۔ اللہ لعنت اللہ علی القوم الظالمین وسیعلم الذین ظلموا ای منقلب ینقلبون انا للہ و انا الیہ راجعون۔ اللہم صلی علی